Alright guys, I'm making a three-part video on making a silverware set. I just finished the fork. Check out the other video, that's where that is. And this one here, we're going to go ahead and do the spoon now. I think the fork and the spoon are the two hardest ones. It's just, there's some technical stuff there that needs to happen. With the fork, you're splitting the time. With the spoon, you got to make this bowl. And quite honestly, I haven't gotten it down pat yet. Well, that's what we're going to do. Stay tuned. This is our project for now. Alright, so we're using 3/8 rebar for the project today. This works okay. It's just so much extra work to get the rebar out, you know, the grooves of the rebar, and turn it into what you want. 5/16 square stock would probably work. 3/8 round stock would certainly work too. What we need to do though is we need a ball on the end of this, or as close to a ball as I can get. So we're going to heat this up, upset that end as much as I can, and then hopefully that'll turn into the bowl. Alright, when it comes to upsetting this, you're trying to only get the heat where you want it to be. So I don't want to be up here as high as I am. But you're really trying to focus that heat on the bottom. That way that's where the action's going to happen. But I mean, it's sometimes it's hard to do. You kind of see what's going on. I'm just after that tip. I'm going to go back, heat it up again, and we'll see what we get out of the upset. Now you can do this on the face of your anvil. Very often I do, especially with smaller pieces. This piece is long enough. I have a block of, actually it's D2 down there. I'm going to use that as my upsetting plane or table. Alright, here we go. So we're just going to throw that down on that table. Don't let yourself get too out of ground here. Where am I? There you go. Back to the anvil, straighten it back up. Do this as quickly as you can so you can get a couple of sessions of upsetting out of one heat. Because as that cools, oops, I missed. The piece that you were trying to upset, that end is going to cool last. So the more times I can go back to that table before it's too cold, the closer I am to upsetting that area that I'm really trying to upset. Oops, I missed again. You kind of see what we got going on. I mean, that's not bad. I'm a little crooked there, but we're going to do that one more time. Very often, it's three times on the upset to get enough steel moved. You can kind of see what we got going on there. It's a little better than it was. It gave me some room for a bowl there. And now before you slam me, I have not mastered the ball on the end of a rod yet. I can't do it. I just need much more practice. What I like to do is approach this like I would a leaf. With a leaf, I put a taper on here to make a point. Well, I want it to be smaller diameter out here anyway, so I'll put a little bit of a taper there. I'll choose what steel I think I need for the ball. That back to the size that I want the handle to be when I'm done. So that looks nothing like a ball, and I really wish it was. Totally round is really what we're after. It's just, I haven't figured it out yet. But I will. It'll happen. Doesn't mean you gotta stop. It might just mean you gotta work harder to get what you want, that's for sure. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna draw this back a little bit more so that I have room to work this spoon more. And then we're going to see what we can do about turning that rectangular shape into a round shape. So again, it's probably not a requirement. I just have to bring this back a little. We'll have to say I'm a little narrower there than I want to be. But it'll be all right. Good enough for now. We're going to come back and spend some time on that. So I'm trying to pretend that is as centered as I can get it. And we're now going to see about making the bowl. Now, what you're gonna see now is persistence compensating for lack of experience. What I'm gonna do is take the cross peen, I'm gonna start putting some width in this. I'm gonna roll this back a little like that on both sides, and that helps get that center out a little bit. I'm pulling back when I'm on the point, trying to move some of that steel back a little bit. Actually use the corner of the cross peen just to try to flatten that out. And again, very often you'll see me hammer in a circle or pushing in a circle. And I don't know for sure if that works very well, but it seems to help move the steel. I'm kind of pulling the steel or pushing it one way or another. So not looking good now, but we'll see what we end up with. Alright, after that first cross peen, I'm just going to go ahead and start flattening it. See what I got going on, and I'm not happy with the way it's going because I really want more width. Now, if you remember this flatter that I made, it's got a nice rounded edge. Now, it used to be a rounded edge, a little bit more than the other hammer. So I'll work that center, and I'm going to hit the front at an angle like this and try to upset some of that steel back. Now, it's too cold right now, but you see how I'm hitting it at an angle, trying to push some of that steel back into this center. I got a half a decent heat here. I'll do a little more work on moving that steel. Now, I'm working the back of the bowl here a little bit. Once I get enough in the back, I can go ahead and start upsetting a little bit off of this front corner. Alright? But it's dangerous. You're going to crack that spoon. Better off to learn how to make that bowl in the first place. Now, again, I'm not showing you how to do it. I'm showing you what I have to do it. There may be a better way to get that thing round to begin with. But I use it with hammer control. And sometimes it just doesn't turn out perfectly round. Like I said, with this project, this silverware set, it's supposed to be rustic anyway, so you got a little bit of grace there, a little bit of leeway to play around.
All right, we'll go back to the regular hammer, we'll see what we can do.
Because I got this jagged edge over here, so I think this is going to be close to a fail here. But we're going to keep working it. Every failure is nothing more than an opportunity to learn something. Now, try to do it the right way, the best you can. But sometimes, by fixing your failures, you can learn something too. So, it's just way too long, right? I either left too much steel or I didn't upset enough. Everything else I think I'm okay with. So I'm gonna go ahead and just nip a little bit of that end off. A good smith shouldn't have to do that. I'll get there someday. And I will be completely honest with you. I like the longer poles. I actually would probably leave this, but I just want you to see that, you know, sometimes you just have to accept that there's certain things that you're not good at, and I have no problem admitting that. The day I say that, oh yeah, that's it, I'm done, I learned everything I need to learn, it'll be the last day I smith. So I'm liking the way that looks. I'm going to go to I'm liking the way that looks. I'm going to go to the vise with the file and just put a little bit extra shape on it, and that's it. That's the way we're going to deal with it. All right, so I'm just putting this in the vise. I'm going to take my file. Just work that bowl shape. I'll try to work left-handed and see if I can do it for you. What do they say about welders? Good welders are good welders, bad welders are good grinders. Well, we all have our shortcomings. So I still have that jagged edge over there on the side. I'm going to go ahead and taper that off a little bit, get rid of that. Not my best work, but we're going to make it function for sure. All right, so I bet you less than 3 or 4 minutes with the file. I got at least, some type of symmetrical shape. It's not round. But like I mentioned before, I kind of like the elongated bowls. It gives more of a spoon than a smaller bowl would. We're going to go back and hammer this out a little bit more and move on with the project. All right, I got the lighter hammer. I'm just going to go ahead and work that edge, get everything the same thickness, get a little bit more width if I can. More shape. I think it's ugly enough to sell. So there's the bowl now. I'm not going to actually put the curve into the bowl until I'm all done because it allows me to handle the steel a little better. Just like with the fork now. Basically everything is the same until we get to that bowl. I'm going to draw this out a little bit more. I'm going to nip it off, flip it around, finish it, put the hook in, and then I'll come back and do the bowl. Alright, just like the fork, I go about out to the width of my anvil. Maybe a little bit more, and just kind of get that square anyway. Preparing it for a twist. It's not bad. Like I said, we got a heat sink out here, so I lose heat quickly. I got enough of it down where I think I have a good distance, you know, a good guess at distance. Nip this off just a little bit beyond where I was drawing it up. Alright, so again, I taper to here and then I nip off a little farther, and that gives me a nice clean piece for my next part. I'm not starting off with an ugly piece. Heat this up, draw it out. Got my recorder. Don't want you to miss it now. These tongs don't work the best for this job. Shoot. Again, it's all your choice. How thick you want it to be. You know, do you want it round, do you want it twisted, do you want it whatever. Every time it's a problem is when you're trying to make a set. Then they gotta be the same size, the same thickness. Or at least it, you need to make it look like you did that. Alright, so here we are, ready for the twist. Alright, here we go, and again I'm gonna put this handle a little bit in the vise because it's so delicate down there. I'll do a tighter twist down here, hopefully without breaking it off, and then I come up here farther and I put a more fluid twist in. It's what I do with these pieces. I kind of like the way they turn out. A million things you could do. Just like with the fork, you see them in the handle on the same heat. You just take that wooden hammer and get that handle so that it looks like it's straight. Boy, that's a big spoon. Extra spoon for a big man or woman, I tell you. So there we go. Got the twist in again. I like that twist. It's, you know, it's, I like it. Feels good in your hand too. All right, we're gonna taper off the end, put the hook in, and we'll come back and do the bowl. All right, go ahead and taper this handle up. Now notice my twist, I didn't finish it at the right spot. I got a point up instead of flat. So now we gotta turn that into flat, which we can do. So we got enough hammering here. Just have to get another heat because of that. So I'm twisting it down, and again with this rebar and a lot of the steels, I start at the point and work my way back so I don't end up with a split out there. Alright, I'm just going to take the extra heat and be right back. Literally about 10 seconds later I'm back. Put that taper in. I don't need to draw this out here. This is plenty long enough.
Holy crap. But we'll get that taper down to a half a decent point. Get it straightened up. I'm happy with that. I'm happy enough. I think that's good.
All right, let's put the hook in. Yeah, I'll talk a little bit about this. Getting ready to do that hook. If I just stick this in the fire, this tip will burn off in just literally a few seconds. So I need to make sure that I got it deep enough in the fire where that hook is hanging out, or I'll dig a hole in the coals around that hook so there's nothing touching it, and that'll help put this into what I call the oven, where the coals are all the way around it. But you gotta watch that tip. You don't want that to melt off now. A good reason to not put the bowl until the end is that if you put this hook in the wrong direction, you can, I mean, by having the bowl not done, you'll make sure it's facing the right way. So, not that I've ever done that or anything.
Back to the heat because I was talking.
So again, with the hook just like the fork, I go ahead and I put a bend in the opposite direction here. Just a little bit, that allows me to bring that hook around. You can see enough anyway. Like that. Gives me that little offset. Dress that up a little. Need tongs for this job. Get her straight as I can. We still got room to work later. There's the hook. Put the twirl on the end. Alright, we'll go for the twirl now, or the scroll, or whatever you want to call it. Just a little run around the end. And like I mentioned in the other video, I like to go tight and then one more turn. And very often I'm taking another heat just like that. But I like that. I like that little extra, that little extra roll that's in there, even though it kind of messes up the hook in the process too. But I like it. So I do the extra work for it. Yeah. Close enough for me. Get one more heat on it to shaping it up. Go back to the anvil. And then we'll just go ahead and clean this up. Get that curvature where I want it to be. A little aggressive in my bend, but I'm happy with that. I like it. Alright, try to go get it semi-straight. It's looking good. So now all we need to do is turn that, I don't know, mini pancake flipper into a bowl. To make that bowl, I'm going to use a block of wood. I want to get set up a little better than this. This happens to be a piece of 2x4. It's pine, so I use it for cutting the edges in my leaves. There is a bowl here from some of the stuff that I've done, but you can actually start off, especially with pine, it's going to burn quick, with a flat spot. You can see here that I start over here. It won't take you long to get a bowl. So, you know, I mean, sure, if you want to take the time to carve that out, go ahead and do so. But it won't take you but a couple of heats and you'll have a nice indentation to get working on. So just a block of wood, a ball peen hammer to work that shape in. That's what I'm going to do. I'll wet this as much as I don't want to because it doesn't help with holding the heat, but it helps keep the wood from burning. So that gets wet just a little bit and I come back with a hot piece of steel. Back, make sure I got my bowl going in the right direction and start on the flat or the semi-indented. I work all the way around it. And then if you have a deeper one, you can go into that. And you just do whatever it is that you need to do to be satisfied with it. Now this is going to be a bit of a bear for me because I can see I have a problem already. But I'm not going to go any farther with the bowl until I fix it. So my bowl is kind of offset there a little bit, so I gotta bring that around. I'm gonna heat that handle up. But you saw very quickly how that bowl was formed. Again, just, you know, hardwood will last longer than 2x4, but especially if you're doing a project for the first time, some piece of pine will burn in a lot quicker. Wet it down to keep the flames at a minimum. All right, so this is gonna be tricky, and this happens to me, where you know it's not gonna be perfect. So you gotta do what you gotta do to make it as not bad. to make it as perfect as it can be. So actually, I'm kind of liking the way that is right now. Again, a little rounder bowl would have given me a little different spoon shape. But for a quick demo, I think that's not bad. Let me quench it. And you can kind of see what we got going on there now. So that hook looks nice. They can either hang it or hook it or whatever they got to do. Feels good. It's actually a big spoon. It's about the handles, I'd say, a good half inch to 3/4 inch too long. Yeah, about that much too long. But handmade, man. Especially by somebody who's just learning, like me. So there you have it. There's the second piece. Previous video was the fork. We'll go ahead. Now, again, you're going to wire brush this up and clean it up. Or not, is your call. This goes into somebody's mouth. I would spend some time on the wire brush on the bowl there. But we'll come back now with the next video and we'll do the knife.